allowing Herdina to take the puck. And Yuri Herdina skates it through traffic up to center to Phil Bork. Bork at the right wing to Yager. McLean's all over him. Yager still brings it towards the net. Yager's in front. He's right there. He shoots and scores! Jaromir Jagr wins it in overtime for the Penguins. And ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has just left the building. Jaromir Jagr, brilliant individual play by the rookie. And the Penguins will leave in the series at one game apiece. What a hockey game. Has been a true Penguin tradition over the last few years, Paul. Here they are outshot 7-2 in the overtime period. They don't need a lot of shots to score, and they cash in, and Jagr with a brilliant individual play to get the game winner.
And as I said, Mike, the fact that the Devils were getting the chances early in the overtime and not scoring was actually a good sign. But the great individual effort by Jagr, who sometimes is criticized for hanging onto the puck too long and not letting go of the shot, but he came down the right wing boards with incredible power on his legs to just hold off John McLean. He was coming down that off wing, of course. He's a right winger and shoots left, so he was able to protect the puck and just cut right in on goal, turn his body and face the net. Terreri went down. He waited and waited to seem like an eternity and threw it up into the net. And he's the number one star of the game. Why not? Jaromir Jagr with a great individual effort to win the game for the Penguins 5-4.
His first goal in Stanley Cup playoff competition, and he'll remember that one the rest of his life. Jaromir Jagr cashed in for the Pens. We'll get the assist for you in just a moment.
I'll tell you, Mike, he looked like a Pied Piper, too. After he scored it, he just kept skating all the way up the ice, and the entire team followed him and finally caught up with him up by the red line and swarmed all over him, and a gigantic win for the Pens.
I told you how strong he is in third periods, and he just came in and just overpowered people, and Jaromir Jagr has an ability to do that.
And he held off McLean.
Yep.
That left arm, he's the man who invented the stiff arm in hockey, like Jimmy Brown. And McLean didn't know what to do. He tried to come around him, but look at the balance and the tremendous skating of Jaromir Jagr. He held onto that puck and then cut in front of the net. Terreri went down, and he was still holding onto it and threw it upstairs. And it went off Terreri, I believe, and into the goal. Unbelievable play by Jaromir Jagr. Now what am I going to do on the postgame show?
Well, I'm not sure. You're going to have to get down there on the radio side. Apparently, what are we?
Well,
I asked our director what we're doing here now as far as finishing up. Well, then let's take the break. Let's take the break right now and come back and tell you tonight the Penguins win in overtime. The game winner by Jaromir Jagr. Final score, Pittsburgh 5 and the Devils 4 here on the Penguins Hockey Network. The game is brought to you by the Pittsburgh Brewing Company, and our Iron Man of the game will be none other than rookie right winger Jaromir Jagr, who scores his first Stanley Cup playoff goal and one he'll remember the rest of his life. Jagr cutting around John McLean and then just balancing down to his knees, came in. Terreri went down and he just held the puck, and went up the ladder to beat him. Actually, off Terreri, it might have appeared to have maybe even hit him in the helmet, and Jagr gets the game winner at 8:52 of the first overtime period, and the Penguins, more importantly, even the season series, the playoff series at one game apiece.